For college and how it's better for us to be the first person to get our applications in, or else we'll get the leftovers and everything that's been picked over. And I'm a person that generally, I'm always looking for the next step, and I'm always comparing myself to other people. And when I compare myself to other people, I'm just like, why am I not prospering at this thing or that thing? Or like, what are they doing different from what I'm doing? For example, my GPA. I always wanted my GPA to be at like a certain level. So my GPA went down from the level that I wanted it to be sophomore year, and I cried in the bathroom for a few hours. So that really, like, you know, that got me to motivate myself to raise my GPA. And I've been trying, and it still didn't go up, and it still went down more. But, you know, maybe this semester might change. But I've always been comparing myself to other people and their abilities, and, you know, maybe it's because, like, oh, I'm not doing this, I'm not doing that, maybe I need a tutor, all that kind of stuff. And I stumbled upon this article by Christopher Hudspeth, and he talks about his love life. And I actually liked this article and thought everybody could relate, like, you know, because we're all, like, you know, we feel like we're failing at some aspect of life. And he talks about his trials and tribulations with his love life and how things... He always sees, like, people, you know, in happy relationships, and the grass always looks greener on the other side. And he wants to know, like, what am I doing different from what they're doing? Why am I not prospering at love? And I actually, like, could relate to that, like, not really with the love aspect, but, like, you know, just, like, my personal goals in general, like grades, for example. And... He talks about his struggles, but he also, like, finds, like, peace with his struggles. Like, we don't know, like, we're always comparing ourselves to other people, but we don't know. We didn't see them when they were struggling. We might see them or hear about them when they're successful, but not when they're down and struggling hard. But that's okay, because, like, we're all gonna have our days, we're all gonna struggle at some point, and then we're all gonna prosper and be okay, so, you know, it's okay. So, I have a quote for you guys, it's so cute. Anyway, it says, this is by Christopher Hudspeth, by the way, so. It says, ultimately, it's important to realize it's all an illusion, a big facade, in which everyone appears to be living comfortably with great love lives. Constant breaks, heaps of success, and problem-free days. Here's the honest, nobody has life all figured out. The older I get, the more certain I am that nobody ever comes near to fully understanding it. And I took this portion of his article to share with you guys because it really talks about how, like, where he is now mentally with what does life mean, and his personal goals and expectations with his love life. And I also think that, well, we can relate, it doesn't matter if you're, like, if it's love that you're failing at, grade, school, or what career you want to take up, if you want to be a doctor, but you're like, oh, that's too much work, too much school, or, oh, maybe I want to apply for Harvard, but I would never get in with my grades. This, like I said, you will